I appear before you with my Kindle in tow. I read on my Kindle every single night. I read a lot. In Goodreads, an app that is connected to your Amazon account and that you can use on Kindle, I track the number of books that I read each year. I set reading challenges, and I've been doing this for the last 6 years. So I took a look at what I'd read and decided to share it with you. Over the last 6 years, I have read 384 books. That's a lot. That's more than a book a week. It's about 64 books a year. Of those 384 books, only 39 got 5 stars from me as a rating. So that's about 10%, which means 1 out of every 10 books that I read earned 5 stars for me. I am super particular about my 5-star ratings. That means that the story just really sunk in with me and pulled me in. I couldn't put it down. I couldn't wait to read. That's what gets 5 stars for me. 4 stars is where you get close to that, but I could put it down. I might've been excited to keep reading it, but it didn't suck me in. 3 stars were, it was a great, easy read. I look forward to reading it, but it didn't hook me. If the book got 1 or 2 stars for me, that means I really struggled to finish. I don't do the Bill Gates thing where he selects his books to be read and he finishes them even if he hates the book. He finishes the book. I don't do that. So if I started a book and didn't finish it, I didn't rate it. I didn't read it. I didn't finish it. I didn't give it its justice. So it just couldn't keep me reading. And so I would never mark it as read, and I would never rate it or review it for an author. I just abandoned it. I have to be in love with the characters and fall deeply into the story. The story has to flow quickly, or if it's nonfiction, it really has to improve my life. When I look at the 2020 books that I read, most were fiction. I gravitate towards fiction reads in the evening. And that's where I do most of my reading. 59 of the 70 books that I read this year were fiction, and then 11 were nonfiction. And I just like an easy to read story as I'm falling asleep. I spend an hour or two reading at night. During the day, I read to the kids, or maybe I read nonfiction, something that requires me to really concentrate and pay attention and be engaged. That's why I save my fiction reads for the evening, so I can just lay in bed and read until I fall asleep. I would like to share with you the 39 books that I have rated as 5 stars over the last 6 years. I'm gonna share them fast. I don't wanna do book reviews or give you commentary or spoil the story for you in any way. So I am sharing them with you. If you're a reader, you can look at the titles and decide if it's a genre for you, if it's a book for you. If you would like to see the other 345 books that I read that I've rated as 1 to 4 stars, you can find me on Goodreads and see the entire reading list and the reading challenges that I set each year. I don't choose books that I think are going to be 1 or 2 stars. A majority of what I end up rating is a 3-star, sometimes a 4-star, and then rarely a 5-star. So let's get started. I'm gonna do 2020 working backwards. So this past year, 2020, I had 4 favorites that were ranked as 5 stars. I'm gonna start with my 3 fiction and my 1 nonfiction that ranked as 5 stars for me. In no particular order, except for chronologically, backwards. Okay, so Little Shop of Found Things by Paula Braxton. The entire series is well-written and very enjoyable. There are 3 books so far. Book number 1 got 5 stars from me. Number 2, Una Out of Order by Margarita Montemore, I think her name is. I will leave links for everything below. A friend of mine recommended it. It's not something I would have chosen for myself normally, and I read it because she recommended it, and it got 5 stars for me. So recommend that one. Number 3, In 5 Years by Rebecca Surley. Number 4 was my nonfiction this year, Make Time by Jake Knapp and John Zertsky, something like that. I'll leave a link below. Let's do 2019. Grit by Angela Duckworth. That was actually a favorite of mine for 2019. Goodbye Things by Fumio Sasaki. That is a minimalist book if you're interested in that. I very much enjoyed that. And he just came out with another book I have to check out. Okay, the next two are by Deborah Harkness, Discovery of Witches and Shadow of Night. The trilogy is excellent and the show is also very good. Number 9, Becoming by Michelle Obama. I very much enjoy that. I also love her, so she could pretty much put dirt on paper and I would read it. Okay, 10 through 16 are all by Susanna Carsley. She's one of my favorite authors. I get drawn into the story so deeply and her characters are so well written and it's of a different time. And these are actually that non-linear story that I typically don't like. This, I loved all of hers. I should probably stop saying I don't like non-linear stories because I do. The 10 through 16 are Shadowy Horses, Splendor Falls, A Season of Storms, Desperate Fortune, The Firebird, Rose Garden, and Winter Sea. 2018, 5 stars from me, Bellwether. It was the first one I ever read by Susanna Carsley. Oh, love it so much. Check it out. If you're going to start reading Susanna Carsley, read that one first. The next two are from another favorite author, also fiction. Amanda M. Lee is the author. Freaky Days and Freaky Rites. Those two were my favorites in the entire series. But the entire series would get 4 stars from me because it's the Mystic Caravan series. I enjoy her books tremendously. Another 5-star favorite from 2018 was A Storyteller's Secret by Sajal Badadi. And then the final favorite from 2018 was Cyberstorm by Matthew Mather. A very thought-provoking book in 2-3 years ago. And if I reread that now, I think I would continue to rate it as 5 stars. It's very, gets you really thinking about technology and our dependence on it. 2017, I only had 2 5-star favorites. Holding Smoke by L. Cusimano. And then The Final Day by William Forstchen. I'm sorry if I'm butchering your names, authors. Oh, sorry. Anyway, his trilogy is excellent. Back into 2016 now. 2 books by Ray Gorham, 77 Days of September and Daunting Days of Winter. They're both post-apocalyptic books. I very much enjoy that genre. So if you do follow me on Goodreads, you're going to find quite a list on there of 3, 4, and 5-star reads. Matt Broly's Dead Lucky also ranked 5 stars for me that year. And 2 books by Robert Crane, Power and Legacy. The rest of his books got 3 and 4 stars, but Power and Legacy got 5 stars from me. And I read 2 biographies that year, Drew Barrymore's Wildflower and Leah Remini's Troublemaker. Going back into the 6th year of this review, 2015. Unravel by Callie Reed, The Book Thief by Marcus Zuzak, 800 Grapes by Laura Dave, very cute, cozy book. I liked that one. Luckiest Girl Alive by Jessica Knoll. A Mythos Grimly by Jeremy Hohalter and Jamie Will. The Martian by Andy Weir. Why Not Me by Mindy Kaling. The Pocket Wife by Susan Crawford. And The Girl on the Train by Paula Harkins. Those are my 39 that over the last 6 years grabbed 5 stars from me. Over on Instagram, I'm always sharing what I'm currently reading, asking you for reads as well. So please comment below with what you are reading, what you would suggest, what your favorites were. And I made a list of the minimalist books that I've read over the last year, because that's a new topic for me. So Joshua Becker's The More of Less and The Minimalist Home. I enjoyed both of those. Regina Wong's Make Space. The Joy of Less by Francine Jay. The Gentle Art of Swedish Death Cleaning by Margarita Magnusson. Easy Minimalist Living by Jennifer Nicole. That's the one that got me to write a thank you letter to my IKEA Calyx shelf before I gave it away. And Goodbye Things by Fumio Sasaki. I might have got more from the library and just didn't mark them on Goodreads. That's possible. Thanks for watching.